So I guess I have to remind you the main formula of the last time, especially for discrete people who weren't there, perhaps. So let's consider a simple example to do that. Say, take this braid, just sigma 1, and we make a small curl here, and we want to bring this small curl to up to near to the boundary. Looks then like that. So we call this a scanning. We have to consider an abstract closure of our thing. So in our case, this is a unique possibility because it should be a circle. That's the same. So what we see in this isotopy, this is a one parameter family of diagrams. So we see Rademeister 2 moves and Rademeister 3 moves. So last time I had a small p and a big p to avoid confusion. So let q be either a triple crossing or so something which looks like that, or an odd self tangency. Something which looks like that. In this braid case, you have all this orientation like that. So what we will do, so here in our case, we have we will have one autotangency, but let me consider the triple crossing. So it will look like that. Okay. So we have numbered these endpoints. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. And here, this small triangle will crash to a point. So we have a distinguished crossing. This is the highest branch with the lowest branch. So D. It's always opposite to this arc which is alternating. There's always exactly one alternating arc, and the distinguished crossing is evidently somehow dual to this arc. So we go along the orientation and we smooth from the undercross to the overcross. We call this D plus D. Now it comes here, now it comes, it continues, it comes to that one. Yes, it comes to that one. As back. So we have d plus d and we have the remaining part, so that will be d minus d. And we consider a small three ball around our triple crossing. And inside we have only the triple crossing, which we have perturbed perhaps slightly. Okay. And we will now associate to this tangle, which is this triple crossing, a linear combination of tangles over some ring. So to this triple crossing, this was our triple crossing Q. So to Q, we associate CQ. Let's call us that a partial smoothing. This is something like sum E, IE, TE, where AI are on our ring. So our ring, it was that V. So we could split the Z and V, let's forget about this for the moment, so not so important. And the TI were tangles with three components, so three tangles in the small ball. Okay, we had the small ball and we consider the boundary, so there will be always 2 of 1 color, so that were, they were, in our case, they were just one red and 2 yellow. So, and we have to connect them, but we have to preserve this color. We connect D plus with D plus, A D minus with D minus. Okay. So, what are the elementary tangles which we could insert, which are the generators of this? Of this gain module, so there, here where we have only one strand, so there's only one possibility, that one. So we make that one. And here in this case, we have two. We could insert this one, or we could insert this one. And all others can be expressed by scan relation from these two. So there's no need to take other ones. We can always say express them as a linear combination of this one. So we will insert a factor of this one plus a factor of this one. Okay, the factor, this is our AI, which depends of the TE. And this expression depends of the local type of the triple crossing. Well, you remember, there were all three crossings positive, or one negative, two positive. We only want that the distinguished crossing, D, always has to be positive. D plus one, the right, so it's crossing like that. And on the global type, so the global type, there were just two of them. It could look like that. Our circle is oriented. Here we need that we close it to a circle, so we are on a circle. So our crossings of arrows always go from the undercross to the overcross. So it could be like that, or it could be like that. So the distinguished crossing, where is it? The distinguished crossing would be that one here. And the distinguished crossing would be that one here. Okay. And it depends. You see, this part here will have only the part where we have one error. And this part will have the two errors. So it could be that the two errors are yellow and the one error is red. Or it could be the opposite. One error yellow and two errors red. Okay. If we have that, now we have now a tangle. We say the local contribution or see R plus contribution. R plus contribution of Q will be the following thing. So we note it like that. We take the sum over this AI, and now we glue to the TI, so there is a TI. The yellow part to which we glue the yellow part outside. Okay. Here we have made this, for example, this one, and here outside comes something like that, and we glue it to that. This gives us what we call it the component D plus I. And we make the same thing for the other one, D minus I. And now we take really P, this is the element in the Homefly PT scan model. This times this, okay, minus I, where P of D I is element in the Homefly PT scan model for the boundary of it, for D D plus D. Okay, or D D minus D. Depends which one we consider. Yeah? So it's just the combination of points in the boundary which will belong to D plus or and the other belong to D minus. Okay, these are really now the products of these elements in the scale model. And now then we sum up. So the definition of R. Keep that for a moment to calculate it. So let S an MT regular. This was the space of all tangles regular isotopic to a given tangle. And S a generic path, generic oriented path. So then we define R plus S to the sum of all Q, where Q are that or that. That is a sine of Q. Sine of Q was that. So we consider another one parameter family which is oriented. We consider the chord diagram which corresponds to these three crossings before and after. So if it goes from there to there, we say it's plus. If it goes in the other direction, it's negative. So we make a Rademeister move forwards and backwards, it will cancel out simply because the signs are opposite. Of course, we need that. And then we take Y, linking number of D. Linking number of D was simply all the intersections of D plus D, the rise of D plus D, D minus D, outside of the small ball of D3D. D3D is this small ball. Okay, so in our picture it's zero. They don't intersect. Huh? It could be that before we had something like that, so it would be two, and so on. Here in this case it would be zero. We take x to the power n of d. N of d is simply the Whitney index of the component d plus d. Well, n of d, Whitney index. D, okay, and then we take that CQT, which we had defined here, okay, and then we remember what was the endpoint, what was the marking of D plus D, so we D plus D, okay. That's the definition of R plus. And of course, there is a dual code cycle. That's a code cycle. There's a dual one, R minus. We take only negative ones. And of course, here, these local pictures will be very different. But same procedure. So the theorem was, this is a code cycle. OK, I have to erase something. I wanted to calculate it in this case. So let's calculate it in this case, just to see. For this triple point, the contribution of this triple point. So the contribution of this triple point, so we have to find out first sine. So we have to consider this chord diagram. So we will make that. There's a nice way to do it, so it will be that. So if it here is that, after we have passed, it comes to that. So that's a plus. So the sign is plus. The sinking lambda is zero. So we will not write it. What is the Whitney index of this? So it's the Whitney index of this yellow thing. So we smooth it with respect to the orientation. We get just one circle, and it is a negative one. Clockwise counts for negative, so it's minus one. So we get, plus of this Q in the scan will be plus x to the power of minus one. Then we have to calculate these local contributions. So what do we see? We have two yellow ones, one red ones. So it will come to that, and there's the yellow ones, that, and the coefficient in this case was plus z. We have to multiply that with the z plus 1 minus y square z. Because this was a positive triple point, so the local type is here was a positive triple point. So local type positive, and the global type, so easy to see. Of course, because we have two yellows, it should be like that. Okay, now you see, we go along the overcross up, and we come to the middle. And then we come to the undercross. As I said, this is the undercross, it's the lowest one, it's the overcross. This is the branch in the middle, so it's okay. So we have to calculate, so this was the local contribution, but we have to glue now the rest of it to it. So let me make the picture of it there. So the red thing will be just this line, so nothing to do. And the yellow thing in the first case, so we will get z times, we have here a crossing. Here we had already one. Plus x square, where we don't have this crossing. Okay. So what is this? We have here unknotted component. This unknotted component, if we take the Homfeld polynomial, it counts for v minus 1 over z. That's easy to calculate from the scaling relations, from the scaling relations. So we have to multiply it by z. So that makes we have v minus 1 for just that. Plus 1 minus e squared. This here is a v minus. V minus 1. So what we get? We get it's equal to v minus y squared times times that. Okay. So we have to insert in our formula. I need the place here. Times v minus y squared times just that. So this is a generator in our Rademeister scaling model. Okay, this is the contribution of this triple crossing. So we have to do this for all triple crossing or self tangences and take the sum. Is that clear? Okay, the theorem, this is a code cycle. So can I erase it? Plus is a one code cycle. The values in this in the Rademeister scaling model of our tangle. Okay, so how to prove that? So just strategy of the proof. So we have this discriminant. So this was our theta sigma 1. Okay, so the events of first degeneration. So we have our generic diagram. So we have here our starting point of our S, and we have our ending point. Okay. And what we have to prove that if we make a homotopy of S, this is our S, we come to an S prime. We have a homotopy, so there's a disk. So we calculated along this arc, it should be the same. This is the property of a one code cycle. Because if it is invariant under homotopy, it will automatically be invariant under homology. Because if we make MOS modifications of our disk, so it means we will split a small circle of it and so on, making MOS modification of index 0, 1, and 2. Evidently, they will not appear exactly in these intersection points. And the intersection points will contribute the same way. So in this space, homotopy homology is the same thing. So it will be a code cycle. So how to do that? So we have to consider two parameter families of diagrams. The disk is a two parameter family of diagrams. So in two parameter families will generically intersect the strat of codimension 2 of the discriminant transversely in isolated points. So we have to study what happened in this case. You see one of these strat here, the transverse intersection of two strat of codimension 1. So that means you have a diagram which has two triple points at the same time. Okay. So we have one triple crossing, and at the same time, our diagram, at another place, we have another one. So we associate something to this, all our contribution. This is Q, plus of Q and S. And here we have a Q prime. We associate something to this, plus of QS, Q prime and S. Okay, and we have to guarantee, so if they intersect, if we come first to say q and then q prime, and then we change first q prime and then q, the result will be the same. Now that's where we need that at usual crossings we do what people ever do, those associating the skein relations. Because you see, these two triple points, they are not at all related. So it could be before, in the first case, it would look like that. Okay, I only draw the planar picture. In the second case, if we make this one, it would look like that. So it's just the usual Rademeister move. So this is an isotopy of the diagram. So we need that outside of our event, it's invariant under isotopy of the rest. So this means we have to use usual quantum invariance, what people always do. So this is the zero-dimensional part comes just from these intersections of transverse intersections of strata. Okay. Therefore, we calculate Homfly polynomial outside of this thing, for something. So that will be invalid. Okay. Second thing, the most important stratum, like always, is the point with the highest multiplicity. So remember, in the zero-dimensional theory, so the hardest thing is to prove invariance under Rademeister moves. That comes to that. So this is a Young-Baxter equation if you associate operators to these crossings. And what we have here, we have a two-parameter family. It will intersect the strata of quadruple crossings. So just you have your triple crossings, one point, and it thus arrives generically in a one-parameter family. And now you have one parameter more. So you keep this triple crossing, and there will be a fourth branch which goes over it. Okay, at some moment you will see a quadruple crossing. It is generic in a two-parameter family. You cannot avoid it. So we have a quadruple crossing. And what we have to prove, if we take this strata, this is sigma of codimension 2, quadruple crossing. So this is a strata of codimension 2. I draw it here in R3 like an arc. That's codimension 2. So we consider the meridional disk of it. It has a meridian. It has a codimension 2 means it's a 2 disk. And we consider its boundary. So we go around this strata. So we have to prove that, call this M a meridian of this strata. We have to prove if we evaluate our invariant R plus on M, it comes to zero. So that means no matter how we come from here, we go here, or we come here, and we go here, it will be the same. If we go once around, it doesn't matter. So that means we can make our homotopy through the strata without changing anything. Okay? So one has to do that. So this is the hardest case. Then there are other singularities. There's a singularity. This is codimension 2, an odd self-tangency with a transverse branch which passes through. So that's a good thing for us because we use these singularities to reduce this equation, like in the case of Rademeister move, just to one move, to the positive quadruple point. So we say the quadruple point is positive. Positive if all crossings are positive. Positive. Okay. French style. Positive, I think. English is the way. Okay. Evidently, in the quadruple point, there are 6 crossings. So you have your 3 crossings of the triple point. And then there's one more branch which passes all. So you have 6 crossings. And so the combinatorial structure of this object is just a tetrahedron. You see, it has 6 edges. The edges are exactly the crossings. And we see there are four types of triple points. So we can, from these four lines, so if we look at from the side, these four lines, which just project one point. So you could drop one, and there will be three, which gives the triple crossing. And there are exactly four possibilities. So these four possibilities correspond to the four vertices of this thing. And if you consider these small vanishing triangles, so you see there will also be exactly four. That, then you see that can vanish and that can vanish. So this will be the faces. Can have duality of that. So therefore it's natural to call this, instead of the triangle equation, the tetrahedron equation. The tetrahedron equation that if you go around this strata, you go along the meridian, that comes to zero. The triangle equation was just you pass the strata from one point to the other, so the boundary was S0 and it is zero. Now the boundary is S1 and it should be zero on S1. So let us analyze that a little bit and to see how it comes. So we have to consider global types of quadruple crossings. So I will explain you in a minute how we come to positive quadruple crossings. But assume we have already the positive one, so we have to consider the global types. So for triple crossings, there were just two global types. So what we have for quadruple crossings, there are six global types. Let me draw them. So now four crossings come to one point. So you see here, these are our six crossings. So the circle is oriented. We orient it by convention always like that. So there's one branch which is the highest. That means all arrows go up to this branch. Say, for example, this one. So this is the highest branch. And there will be one which is the lowest. So the lowest could be here. That means all arrows go out of it. Okay, and you see this arrow is free. It could be like that or like that, no matter. There wouldn't be any contradiction, so we repeat that. So here we take it like that, here we take it like that. So it could be that, say, the highest branch is that, and the lowest branch is that. So again, we have two possibilities. This arrow could be like that or like that. And there are two a little bit fancy possibilities. It could be the lowest and the highest are on the diagonal. So we can always assume that this point is here to the right. Here too. And again, we have one arrow which we can choose free. It could be like that or it could be like that. That's all. These are the six possibilities. So we have to solve six tetrahedron equations, six positive tetrahedron equations for each of these possibilities. So let me just show you one of them, say this one. So by the way, which is the distinguished crossing of the quadruple crossing, so highest arc with the lowest arc? If I draw it, it is here. Here it is here. Here is it here. It's here. And here it's on the diagonal. Okay, so these cases are really different from the other. And they make more problems. So let's consider this case. Okay, so if we go around, so we have, that's a bit confusing. This is, on one hand, this is a picture of the projection of a quadruple crossing. But on the other hand, this is a picture of the intersection of the normal disk of this quadruple crossing in this infinite dimensional space with the strata of codimension 1. And it looks the same way. That's just by accident, which doesn't make things easier. So on each of these is a strat of sigma 1, which looks like that. There's one triple point and one arc which goes around. Because all crossings are positive, I can draw just planar pictures. On a planar picture, you can reconstruct all crossings. And because all orientations here are not orientations, because we consider points like that, so it will be okay. Whatever planar picture, whatever Rademeister 3 move we make, it's really a Rademeister 3 move with this orientation. Okay, so we have to see how it looks like. What do we see on like strata? Now it becomes a bit complicated, so let me have a look on it. So I will not show you how it goes all around this point. Oh, where is it headed? I'll have it here. Okay, so I have to figure it out. Okay. So it can look like that. You have what, like strata. Oh, wait. I noticed something. So there's one strata which looks like that. So here's our triple point, and then it comes like that. Oops, all orientations are like that. Okay, yes. Then we could see it on the other side. It's the same triple point, but this thing has moved to the other side, so it will go like that. So we could see this one, which looks like that. It's another one, and here it comes like that. Now it comes to the other side. Oops. Okay, and we will see four other strata. These four other strata look like that. To one side, other side, and that one. Oops, comes like that. So the good news are these four strata, we don't need them. Why we don't need them? Because so if we consider this unfolding, it's called an unfolding. So this is our disk. So we consider this strata, so this one. So it comes here in and it goes out smoothly, because this triple point hasn't changed. It's the start of a triple point. Just the fourth branch has changed its position with respect to it. And we go along. We have a co-orientation on it. Okay, the co-orientation is continuous, and we go along our line. Our meridian. So you see here it would have a negative sign. If we come here, it has a positive sign. So if the contribution of this one and this one is the same, they would cancel out because signs are different. So what is the contribution? Remember, what we are we doing with this point? We replace this by some combination of tangles like that. So here it's again. Oops, same combination. But look at the fourth strand. The fourth strand here is either all over it or all under it, because if all postings are positive with orientation. So here, for example, it would be all over. Here it's again all over. Still all over. Okay. And you see, whatever we do here at this moment, this branch we can still bring over it. It's an isotopy. And I explained to you what we consider in the complement only up to isotopy. So what we calculate here and what we calculate here will be the same, evidently, because they have the same Homefly invariant in the scan model. They are isotopic for each of these, C, Q, or not C, Q, T, the EQT for each of these DE, D minus E, which we got, they are an isotopy. So they cancel out. So these four strata will cancel out. So we remain with these four strata. They will not cancel out. Why? Because if you make here the realistic picture, so let me make it here, they are positive. So it looks like that. Here it's positive. That goes over. Here it goes over. You see, you are blocked at this point. You cannot push it through here. Just because we have the distinguished crossing there. If we smooth it here, we can push it smooth with the triple crossing, but we cannot push it smooth where we have smoothed here something, for example, like that. You see, we will get blocked here. So these are really different. So they will give contributions. So in our case, so we look in this picture, where is the highest branch, where is the lowest? So I really have to draw it a little more precisely. Draw it a little more precisely. So this was the highest branch. Then this comes under it. So this is a triple point. I make this one. This comes under it. Then this one comes under it. So I make it like that. And here it comes like that. So it was positive. Over, under, under. Okay. So we know that in this picture, so we consider just this case. In this picture, we see what? We see that the highest branch, if we go along the circle, comes to the lowest branch directly. So the highest branch is this one, it comes to the lowest branch. So it will be connected with this. The rest we already don't care, not much. It's not so important. This is, so we see our red component will be just that. Oops. Okay, so this now local picture, now we see our red component in all four pictures. Because the most important thing is that these four strata, so they have four different triple points, but they have all the same distinguished crossing. You see it immediately in this picture. So where are these? There are this triangle, and there's this triangle. So these are these four strata, which give these four strata. Because we see each twice. We said on one side of the quadruple point and on the other side. So it's the same triangle. So it's this one and this one. And you see they share this crossing. That's the important thing. This distinguished crossing is the same. It's completely different for the remaining two triangles. There are no other distinguished crossing which is shared. So, but we can now, in our pictures, draw this component. So it will be that. Yep, it's lost. I have to restore it. Yeah. Lost. Okay. And we see we have these two components. Here we have to replace it by different things. So let's make it. Let's just solve the equations in this case. Of course, we have to check the global sign. Not do it. Just tell you, this will be a plus. All right, to be sure. Yeah, this will be a plus. So this is on the other side. So this will be a minus. So this one, not to mix it. This one when it is down there, yeah, this one. Before, it's a minus. This one is a minus, so this one will be a plus. Okay, so what do we see? So let us introduce variables. So if we make this one, we have two tangles in our ball. So if we replace it by that, we say, with a coefficient alpha, and if we replace it by that, the coefficient beta. We can't do anything else because these are the generators of the scan model of two tangles, of the Homfeld Petit polynomial. So what do we get? We see the red line here, we have two positive crossings. So we get a y square as a factor. Okay, we get plus y square times what? We make alpha times here the crossing. Times when it makes a crossing, it looks like that. And then we have the third. I can forget the red one. Yes, like that. And then one comes like that. Okay. Plus y square beta, where this point is now like that. Correct? Okay. Then let's consider the minus one there. Now the y has disappeared. There are no longer virtual crossings. So these two crossings between the two components disappeared here. So there we will get minus alpha. If we replace it by that, what will it give? We see there's a double point. It will give that. Right? Right. Alpha z minus beta. So that has not changed. That has not changed. And here it comes to that. Right? Yeah, right. Beta z. And we go on. So then it comes to that. Here we have again y minus y square alpha. It gives that. And this thing comes here minus y square beta. Now it comes to that. And that and that. Okay? Yeah. Then plus that, plus alpha. So if we make that, it will look like that. Plus beta, it comes to what? So this will be that like that. It's like that. Okay? Yeah, I hope it's all right. That's all. And that should be zero. If we sum to all this up, it's zero. So let's solve it. So you see, we can apply scan relations here. So this thing is the same because all three crossings are positive. This is a Rademeister move. It's isotopic to this. We can make it there. Okay, exactly the same thing here. We can move it here. So this is not a Rademeister 2 move because both are positive. So we have to apply the scan relations. So we end up with what? So we have eigen y square alpha that plus y square beta that. So I already there are no scan relations. Minus square alpha that minus square beta that. So this is already fine, this cancels out. So and then we have scan relations. So we have to change, say, this crossing into a negative one, okay, and then we can eliminate this two. So it means we have minus alpha times that, okay, but we have the scan relations say, so this thing is equal to that, if we have changed, so I have to draw it, plus that times that. Okay, so we have to smooth it here. If we smooth it here, we get so minus alpha that times that. They are all positive.
Okay, then here again, minus beta, we change it, it will give that. Minus beta times, that stays here. And minus beta z, we smooth it, it comes to that. Okay, see, we smooth this crossing, we'll be with z. And then plus alpha, we eliminate it. This comes to z, plus alpha z, which comes to the triple, plus beta, comes to z, plus beta z, which comes to that. Okay, eliminate this one, yeah, it goes like that. Okay, it should be zero. So let's see what happened. We say the triple point cancels out. Fine. What else? Beta cancels out. That's all. We see with just two configurations, these non-symmetric configurations, and this gives us two equations. Okay, that's why the equations.